things that we just talked about. Hello, this is your girl, Perfectly Imperfect. This is part two, and it's just basically a rant about Nature Boy Army. So I was obsessed, of course. I talked about that. I watched him every day. I watched how he would take and couple up the women and men together. Then eventually he would want the women back as his wives. You know, he would pass off, you know, the ladies to a particular man in the camp and make them, you know, couple up. And, you know, once he seen that the women were happy and the relationship was going smoothly, it's like he turned on them. It's like he was angry. Like, he doesn't want anybody to be happy or enjoying, you know, their life. You know, if it's not chaotic or you're not halfway dying around him, like, he's not going to see forth that you're going to do great or be great in your life, because he doesn't want that. He's like the ultimately hellraiser of a man. I've never seen so much monstrous behavior in a human being in my life. Like, it is just hard to watch. And every other word is all about sex. And, you know, it's like, oh, I thought this was supposed to be a camp of enlightenment, of teaching us something that we didn't know. Like, I didn't think it was all about the poly and how many women you can get and pull and bring here and have sex with them and have, you know, abortions or kill-offs or whatever you're doing over there. You know, I thought this was literally a place of peace for anybody, not just white, not just black, but anybody. I thought this was like a heaven on earth situation. Turns out it's just like the heaven's gate is what it's feeling like. It's like, but it's just crazy, you know what I'm saying? And it's disgusting to just be there and to keep having to be forced, woke up, like, you can't rest. Like, if he wants you to go 3 or 4 hours in and talking on the internet, you have to do it. It's all these things that he expects out of you. He literally is a vampire, energy vampire. He's just taking the energy of you. And how I explain that is, like, you can go over there and be like 20 or maybe even 30 years old. And then after being there months with him or whatever, you start to look like you're 60, 70 fucking years old, and you're only 20 or 30 years old. He drains the life out of you. It's like he sucks you open. You know what I'm saying? And, you know, that's how I, you know, just decided that wasn't for me. Like, I'm not going to tolerate somebody torturing me like that. It's like, you're not going to be in my ear 24/7. You're not going to tell me what to eat and how to eat, and I didn't put my money in the pot too. You're not going to restrict my meals. You're not going to restrict my being healthy and having medication and going to the doctors. He wouldn't allow them to go to the doctors, you know. It's just so much that he was causing the members to just, any livelihood they have in them, you know, is draining it out. Like, they're not happy. They're not flourishable. You would think he would want his women to be beautiful. And when I say beautiful in a natural beauty, I'm not talking about makeup and all of that, but he would want them to thrive. If he had any love and care, that it let me know that he didn't have any love and care. The more I watched him, it let me know he had no love and care in him. It was all about him and him being a spotlight, him and his donation, him having the members use their name to fill the pot for the donations.